Hey all, welcome to Sharetrek. This is Raj here. Friends, today I'm going to talk about a new development that could potentially open up bone marrow transplant to do CCR5 mutation and provide functional cure to HIV patients. And before you get too excited, let me also take the opportunity to add that our channel is now having subtitles for English videos like this one in around 12 to 15 different languages, and I've made sure that I cover the major language so that most people in the world would be able to benefit from our videos. Some of the top languages are French, Spanish, Portuguese, German, and in Africa I have got Swahili, Sudanese, Somali, and Afrikaans, four major languages out there. So I think everybody should benefit from our videos. And now to know more about this groundbreaking approach, let's first look at the disclaimer and then get started. Well friends, what I'm going to talk about today is to be found in a company called CRISPR Therapeutics. They are not doing HIV therapy right now. They are working on an advanced method of targeting HSCs or human stem cells in the bone marrow in order to cure a disease called sickle cell disease. Let me show that to you on the pipeline of this company. This is the pipeline of CRISPR Therapeutics, and one of the items out here is CD117 ADC. In vivo HSC editing. In vivo means inside the body, gene editing is being done. So the description here is that enabling delivery of CRISPR-Cas9 to hematopoietic stem cells in vivo to bypass the need for ex vivo gene editing and hematopoietic stem cell transplant. What this means is that this company is in very early stages of a therapy where within the body, editing will be done in the stem cells so that the stem cells will produce really good quality blood cells and help the patient to avoid sickle cell disease. This is groundbreaking, but what I'm looking at it and finding is that if I project it forward and look at the possibilities that are there, number one, it could make bone marrow transplant much more comfortable for the patient and increase the pool of patients and the pool of ailments for which patients could be eligible for bone marrow transplant. So that's point number one. Point number two is that the same method that is used for curing sickle cell disease, it could be used for putting the CCR5 mutation into the stem cells in vivo in HIV patients and thereby giving them functional cure for HIV. So that's the second possibility I'm seeing. Let me elaborate on this. I'll just take a few minutes so that you can understand this concept. And I don't want you to get unduly excited because this is early stages and I'm hoping that this therapy will succeed. I'm keeping a close watch on it and I'll bring you more updates as we go ahead. Now, let us start off with the first possibility. What CRISPR Therapeutics is doing right now is that they are using the anti-CD117 element, which can attract itself to latch with CD117 that is found only on HSCs or human stem cells. And having done that, the LNP will be in close proximity to the stem cell and it can release gene editing payload into the stem cells to make edits to cure sickle cell disease from a functional perspective. Now, what I am suggesting is that a company could come along, even CRISPR could do that. They have not announced it right now, but they could also do it if this goes through well in terms of targeting CD117. They could put a CRISPR-Cas9 edit in place so that the CD4 T cells produced by these stem cells could have the CCR5 mutation and thereby confer the patient with functional cure for HIV. This is the first possibility. It could be done either by CRISPR Therapeutics. They have not announced it. They have not mentioned it at all. Or it could be done by some other companies that could decide to take this approach to cure HIV. Now, the second possibility is that CRISPR can also go ahead and load a cytokine instead of the gene editing tool into this configuration so that when this therapy is introduced into the body, it will go on and the LNP will latch on to human stem cells using the CD117 receptor. and then it can unload the cytokines in the vicinity of the stem cells and kill the stem cells in a very specific manner, so that there is no side effects of other sorts which are found in the chemical and also found in the radioactive method of doing myeloablation right now. As a result of which, that method will be way more superior to the chemical and radiation methods of clearing out the bone marrow and preparing it to receive new stem cells for engraftment. Now, if you look at the current state of play, the standard of cure for HIV is ART, and ART is giving a pretty good quality of life for the patient without having too much of problems to justify going for a stem cell replacement. If you notice the history of all the people who got bone marrow transplant and survived and became functionally immune to HIV, they were all people who were suffering from some kind of blood cancer, and they were in terminal stages, and it was required that they get a bone marrow transplant, and that opportunity was taken to put CCR5 mutated stem cells into the bone marrow and confer on them the immunity. Now, what will happen is if the anti-CD117 gentle conditioning agent was successful in clearing out the bone marrow in a very, very targeted manner without affecting any other part of the body, then it will become way more superior than the current method of chemical and radiation, because the chemical and radiation methods go all over the body. They are indiscriminate, and they also potentially lead to malignancies of cells in the liver, kidney, lungs, and other organs. And therefore, it's very high risk. The new gentle conditioning agent will be so targeted that it will be lower risk. The only risk factor out there is cytokine poisoning. So they can graduate the dose and progressively clear out the bone marrow, I suppose. That's the speculation I'm making. I'm still studying on this. But if they manage to do that, then we'll have a new gentle myeloablating agent, because of which stem cell transplant for HIV treatment could become a reality, because with this kind of a stem cell cleaning, a second approach towards curing HIV could be taken. Now, let's look at the second type of therapy that can come up with this. Using this gentle myeloablation tool, if it makes HIV patients also eligible for bone marrow transplant because the side effects and the risk threshold has reduced significantly, then we could have a company that may decide to harvest the bone marrow of the patient, make gene edits outside the body to suppress the CCR5 receptor in CD4 T cells. And after the modification is made, the myeloablation can be done. And then the modified genetically edited HSCs can be put back into the body so that they go and engraft onto the emptied out bone marrow and start producing new CD4 T cells which are which have the CCR5 mutation, and then that will confer HIV functional cure to the patients. Now, this is something that will be similar to what AGT-103-T is doing, because right now AGT-103-T is harvesting CD4 T cells and making the modifications to suppress the CCR5 and then introducing it back into the body. So you can see the possibilities. That's what I got excited about, and I thought you guys would be excited to hear about this possibility. So this is something you would not hear in any other channel, friends. And I keep on looking at a lot of gene therapies, and I keep on studying up on it because I invest in gene therapy stocks. And I have another channel called ShareTrek where I continue to look at all the different kinds of gene therapies that are being developed. And where they are in the clinical trial, what are the problems they are facing. So I'm able to put all these things together and come up with these ideas to talk to you about the possibilities. You won't find this anywhere else on YouTube. So I would suggest that, you know, always press the notify button, stay subscribed, and you don't miss any of my videos. And my special thanks to all the members who have been helping with this channel. Stay subscribed as members and encourage others, you know, also to become members so that I can continue to get the motivation to keep this going and come to you with even more insightful videos that can give you hope and also information on where the cure, the search for cure for HIV is heading. With that, my friends, I'd like to bring this video to an end, and I want to hear from you what you think of this particular approach. And if you have any insights, please let me know. Thanks and have a great day. Bye for now.